a real estate and finance expert that goes to bat for you every day as a consumer advocate. Your host and the consumer quarterback, Brandon Rhymes.
And we're blessed and highly favored here in studio with Jim Mccune in the house today, America First Patriot Store, joining us in studio as well. Alex BlackBelt Lima, as always, in the co-pilot seat here. And got some interesting stuff. I'm going to play a clip about J.D. Vance, his background, his story. Very interesting. The American dream at its best. I love the overcoming adversity there, the story there with J.D. Vance. And, of course, we're going to feature a couple of our listings and a feel-good story coming up for you today as well. This is an interesting feel-good story, one of my favorites. Families in tiny Texas town have adopted 77 hard-to-adopt kids inspired by their Baptist church leaders. There's your feel-good story of the day coming out of Possum Trot, Texas. There you go. Possum Trot. How's that for a small town name, right? Possum Trot, Texas, inspired by their Baptist church leaders. So feel-good story coming up. It's out of the Sound of Hope film as well from the Angel Studios. Angel Studios, one of the popular studios that had put out The Chosen, and they also put out the Sound of Freedom story, movie rather, coming up here on the show. So, all right. Couple of hot listings here. We got 221 Howard Drive. I love this $1 million listing. $3.4 million listing. Howard Drive. 221 Howard Drive, Bel Air Beach, Florida. Five bedrooms, three bath, 3,500 square foot condo, a single family home, that is. Exclusive Bel Air Beach location. Gorgeous three island kitchen with Thermador appliances, salt water pool, 100 linear feet of water frontage on deep water. Now, historic Howard Drive boasts one of the highest land elevations in the area, and you're also one block from the beach. 221 Howard Drive, Bel Air Beach, Florida. Beautiful $1 million listing. Compliments of Aaron Foley on the Platinum MVP team at Keller Williams Realty. All right, we're going to stick on the beaches here. We got Gulf Boulevard. Beautiful property on Gulf Boulevard, Indian Shores. This one is Unit F. Three bedrooms, three bath, 2,000 square feet, beachfront condo on the beach. You are literally walking out of your front door, past your heated pool, and you're going right onto the beach. Sugar sand beaches, dolphin-filled waters, 18522 Gulf Boulevard, Unit F, Indian Shores. Now, one of the best things about this property is, yes, you can short-term rent this condo, and it's only $250 a month for the HOA fee. Super low HOA fee for a $1 million listing. Three bedroom, three bath, 2,000 square foot, 18522 Gulf Boulevard, Unit F, Indian Shores. And you can see all of our real estate listings at platinummvpteam.kw.com. That's right. Shout out to our veterans out there, our troops. And we're going to talk a lot about America First today on the program with Jim Mccune. Quick shout out to my friends at Heights Soft Wash before we jump into it. If you're thinking about pressure washing residential, commercial properties, heightssoftwash.com. Make sure you let them know the real estate quarterback sent you. I know the owner. His name is Ramin. Great guy, great businessman, great company, heightssoftwash.com. Let them know the real estate quarterback sent you. All right, so America First is the theme of the show. Welcome in, welcome back, Jim Mccune. Welcome in, sir.
It's great to be here with you, Brandon.
Yeah, hey, my pleasure, man, and I love the idea. You know, America First Patriot Store is our business that we're going to be talking about, but just the simple idea of America First and making America great, right? I mean, how does that resonate with you?
Well, I'm a great patriot. I'm a former Navy veteran, and I've always been a patriot. Actually, I was on a football scholarship, and I dropped out of I decided not to go back to college after my second year to join the Navy because I was so patriotic during that time.
Wow.
That really is true. I went back and finished.
Imagine a kid doing that today, right? Like, not to disrespect any kids that would, but, you know, you just then generally you think that wouldn't happen so much today. But back then it was more of like, hey, man, I'm going to go serve my country. I'm going to do the right thing.
That's exactly how I felt, and I certainly don't regret it. It was a great experience for me. I wouldn't have stayed for 20 years, but I enjoyed the 4 that I was there.
Yeah, that's great, man. I love that. So you're a Navy veteran. You were on a ship, a vessel?
Submarine tender. I was a welder, in the Navy, yeah.
Wow, super cool, man. Interesting background. So what are you doing today? What's America First Patriot Store? Tell us a little bit about this business.
Well, it's a company that I've been shopping with them for, gosh, for 30 years now. And they have the best products that you can get anywhere. You join and you become a member and you shop with them. It's kind of like Sam's or Costco or BJ's or something like that, except you don't get a card with a bad picture on it. You can join, you know, for $19 for a whole year. They have a special going this year, or at this time it's only $1. And you shop with them for products that you fall in love with. My wife and I fell in love with the better, safer, more economical products that they manufactured right here in America. We love that part. And we actually found that their great products were better, safer, and actually more economical on a cost-per-use basis than anything we're already buying. And we wouldn't have to spend any new money. We'd save time, money, and gas. Don't have to go down to the store and all that kind of stuff all the time. And so, you know, with me, I've shopped with them all that time because they have the best stuff you can finally find anywhere.
Yeah, I like that, man. So you're shifting your buying habits. I think it's true to the overall theme of buying local, buying patriotic, shopping from a company that is patriotic. It's Christian conservative. It more aligns with the values of our audience for sure. And can you talk a little bit about that side of the business? Because I think that's such a thing, such a key element today. People are looking for that economy. What's the word I'm looking for? That secondary economy or that new economy that's America First.
Absolutely. And so the thing about it is that you're just switching from the big box stores. And when you look at it, you find that all of them are controlled by BlackRock, State Street.
Yes.
Vanguard.
Yep.
And they see that those companies, they basically own all 11 brands that you find in the stores. They essentially they control everything we buy.
Right.
And so what I did, I asked myself, well, why should I continue to buy from them? Many of their products are, you know, toxic. If you look at the label on the back of some of them, they say hazards to humans and domestic animals. Like, who else is there? Right? And so all these companies, most of them have gone woke. They literally control the shelf space in all the stores, and all the choices that we seemingly have are controlled by the same people. So I realized at this point I've been shopping with a great company that manufactures over 400 different products in 11 categories, and including prime and high choice beef that you've tried, right?
I love the steaks.
I know. They're absolutely amazing. And I wanted to share it with as many people as I possibly could. And it's a chance for us to vote differently with our shopping dollars. And I really hope that people will take a good look at it, because if you go to the AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com, you can see some information on there, have a little video of you.
Yeah.
That's great. And then we'll give them some information if they're interested.
Yeah, yeah. And then, so I love that. AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com. Check them out online. And it's just a great opportunity to shop closer to your heart, closer to your morals and values. And it's that alternative economy that we want to support, because as Jim so eloquently mentioned there, a lot of the companies that you look out there, it's the illusion of choice, right? It's like some of the big names you hear, like Procter & Gamble, General Mills, et cetera, and even, you know, companies like Anheuser-Busch. Remember when it came out with the transgender guy on the beer? What was his name? Mulvaney. You know, and it's like, oh, I'm not going to buy that Bud Light. But then you still drink the other types of beers, which was it's the Mexican, the one Mexican beer. But they own all these different brands.
It's within the network, yeah.
Yeah, it's like 30-something brands of beer that they own. So so the idea here is let's diversify. Let's spend money with America First Patriot Store, which Jim is, you know, here talking about today. And here's another story that just came out. I just printed these off today, and it kind of lined up perfectly for what we're talking about. But it talks about Prime Day. This was a story I pulled down off of LinkedIn. Prime Day, of course, Amazon, the behemoth seller of goods, major cause of injuries. So there's been a study, I guess, it's talking about how, you know, bargain-hungry shoppers, with sales up 12% this year by one early measure, but the annual sale has drawn scrutiny from lawmakers. Senate investigations found that it's a major cause of injuries to warehouse workers. A year-long probe as part of the data provided by Amazon employee interviews found out 45 out of 100 workers were injured during the 2019 sale. A spokeswoman told the Washington Post, report draws sweeping and an inaccurate conclusion. So anyways, you know, when you're buying, when you're swiping, even though it is, you know, pretty convenient to go on there and buy things, but just think about it, you're supporting these woke organizations, you're supporting for example abortion, you're supporting this transgender nonsense. I mean, all of those different things that you're supporting there, Jim.
Absolutely. And you know, most of the people, when I started listening to your program, I don't know if I told you the story once. I was my wife sent me over to Publix, and I was listening, had you on the radio there, and I was listening to it, and it was so interesting that I decided, well, I'm not going to this Publix because I want to continue listening. I drove all the way up to Plant City so I could listen to the rest of the program. And the people, you know, there's so many people out there, a lot more than they let us know, the woke media, you know.
Sure.
That believe in family values, the love of the Constitution, and the American way of life. And we know that people, once they are introduced to this company and their products, that they'll feel the same way. What happens is, you know, they have over 450 different products now that people already use. Everybody has to shower, shave, shampoo, use deodorant and toothpaste, clean the house, wash their clothes.
Yep.
About 80% of the people take nutritional supplements. Most women love essential oils.
Yeah.
The average lady spends $700-$800 per year from the neck up on skincare and cosmetics.
Wow.
And those are the things that we have.
Yeah.
And what happens is the average family spends about $200 a month somewhere on these types of products.
Yeah.
Think about that. Over the year, that's $200 a month. That's $2,400 a year. Of the next 10 years, you're going to spend $24,000 with those woke companies that do not share your or my values.
Yeah, sure.
And that's what I loved about it from the very beginning, because like I say, I've been a patriot from the very start.
Yeah, I love it. Likewise, myself as well. Growing up, you know, it wasn't this, you know, growing up, Alex, you know, kind of our generation too, you think about our, you know, it really wasn't at the forefront. It wasn't like, oh, are you Republican or Democrat, until you got into your, I don't know, in the 30s, and it got worse. And now, you know, in my 40s, it's like at your throat. It's like, oh, I can't support those people. Or, you know, it's just gotten worse and worse progressively over time, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's awful, man. You know, I remember as a kid, like, I never once had a problem standing up. We did our morning announcements, talking elementary school.
Yeah.
Morning announcements, you stand up, what do we do? Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge Allegiance to the Republic, not the democracy, the Republic.
Yep. And then they played at my school, at least, every time after the Pledge of Allegiance, they played the Proud to Be an American, where at least I know I'm free. They played the song, and then that was it. You know, and I was never one of the kids that was like, oh, man, we got to do this. I was like, it's just what we did. This is my country.
Cool.
I love it. Why don't we do it? You know?
Yep.
And then, over time, you know, they're taking that. They're taking, you know, trying to take God out of schools and just out of lives, period. And we need to get back. Everybody needs to fine-tune their moral compasses and remember that this is your country. So
that's,
you know,
right.
Act right. This is our house.
Yep. And Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior. Hey, quick shout-out to J.D. Vance. Listen to this.
Now, one of the things that drew the Trump campaign to Vance in the first place, beyond his policy record, is his biography. Whatever anyone thinks of his political views, it's impossible to deny that Vance has embodied and lived out the American dream, overcoming extreme poverty, abuse, and family trauma, to now become one of the country's most important political figures. Typically, when a VP choice is made, folks go to their Wikipedia to learn about their background. But in this case, again, there's already a hugely popular book and film about his life. And millions of Americans are now turning to that story to learn more about their potential next vice president. To that point, the paperback and hardcover editions of his book, Hillbilly Elegy, now hold the number one and two spots on the Amazon bestseller list, while the film starring Amy Adams and Glenn Close is now the fourth most streamed movie on Netflix.
Wow. So Republican voters seemingly very enthused by the pick.
Yeah, super awesome, right? I mean, so I like J.D. Vance. I'm on the Vance train. I love the choice. I love the movie. I just watched it again a few weeks ago before the pick, actually. It was kind of just timing-wise. So like, you know how it is. It's been a couple of years since you saw a movie. You're like, I'll watch it again. My mom had not seen it. So, but yeah, what a great story. He's overcoming adversity. He had all these issues with his family. His mom was an addict. So that is a true American story. If you want to fight and you want to go and get educated and you want to make something of yourself in America, you can still do that. No excuses, right?
Absolutely. I can't relate to some of the things there, but you know, I was raised in a little coal camp up in West Virginia called Pity Me Holler.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and there were seven of us, four boys, three girls, and all four boys got scholarships. That's how we got out of there.
Yeah, exactly.
Athletic scholarships. And
work
and,
hard.
Yeah, really. And so you can understand why I love this country. It's allowed me to, you know, I've been very successful over the years.
Yeah.
I was a high school principal years ago.
Cool. And, That's awesome.
The thing about this Patriot company here, when people shop with them, if they become a member, they get a 30% to 50% discount. All their products come with a 100% satisfaction guarantee for 60 days, and they have a monthly reorder rate of 96%.
Wow!
So that means if 96 people out of 100 order on a monthly basis, the products must be really good and reasonably priced.
Right.
They wouldn't do that, would they?
Right.
Absolutely they wouldn't. And here's what a lot of people don't realize. When you shop at those big box stores,
yep,
63 cents out of every dollar goes for advertising, distribution, middlemen, and things like that.
Good point.
Adds no value to you and me.
Good point. Yep.
What happens here is this company manufactures their own products. They don't have to pay for shelf space, middleman, or advertising. Like a sudden, that allows them to pass the savings on to you and me.
Makes total sense.
Yeah, they really,
I love that.
You really will save money shopping with this company.
I love it. We're going to take a quick break there. Check out AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com. AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com. Jim Mccune in studio with us. Mr. Attitude in studio with us here on the Consumer Quarterback Show. And more with him coming up. Also, feel-good story of the day. You don't want to miss this one. Families in a tiny Texas town have adopted 77 hard-to-adopt kids inspired by their Baptist church leaders. The movie Sound of Hope embodied in this story. Coming up here on the Consumer Quarterback Show, ConsumerQB.com.
Thanks for listening to My Daddy's Show. Please make sure to send him all of your real estate deals and subscribe to the Consumer Quarterback Show podcast on iTunes and Spotify, or check out our YouTube channel. Have a blessed day.
To get in touch with Brandon, call 727-263-3707. Online at ConsumerQB.com.
Dennis Prager here for Brandon and Lindsay Rimes, owners of the Platinum MVP team at Keller Williams. Buying, selling, investing in real estate, their nationwide Keller Williams network makes them the best team to work with. Sellers, have your property featured live on air, creating multiple offers. Buyers, leverage a unique system that gets your offer accepted, never overlooked. Call or text 813-750-0550, 813-750-0550, or consumerqb.com.
Lindsay Rimes here with Archer Place in Gainesville, Florida. Our luxury condo community is located only 1.5 miles from the University of Florida, 5 minutes to Shands Medical and Butler Plaza. Our buyers love the high-end luxury amenities in their building, including a state-of-the-art fitness facility equipped with Pelotons, the resort-style temperature-controlled pool accompanied with cabanas and grills, and the gourmet chef's kitchen in our clubhouse that overlooks the pool. We have pre-construction pricing only for a limited time, with floor plans ranging from a one-bedroom, one-bath to two-floor penthouses with plunge pools. Starting in the low 400,000s to the high 900s, investors, parents sending their young adults off to school, medical professionals, business owners, and entrepreneurs alike are investing in these residences. Reach out to us today at 727-263-3707 to get more information.
You're listening to The Consumer Quarterback, Brandon Rimes, online at ConsumerQB.com. Brandon is Tampa Bay's number one consumer advocate for real estate and financial advice. Call Brandon today at 813-917-1894.
And we're back. Brandon Rimes here, your host of the Consumer Quarterback Show, top real estate agent, listing agent here in Tampa Bay, certified negotiation expert, published author, also teaching classes at the realtor boards here in Tampa Bay. A couple of hot listings, then we're going to talk more with Jim Mccune. He is a partner on AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com. AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com for all your shopping needs there. All right, we got a property at 3615 C. Robin. This one's in St. Petersburg. Beautiful property here. Completely remodeled, renovated home. Three-bedroom, two-bath. Almost 1,500 square feet. Remodeled single-family home. 3615 C. Robin Drive, Southeast St. Petersburg, Florida. You have the kitchen has beautiful stainless steel appliances, breakfast bar, tiled backsplash. Kitchen provides easy access to the backyard through a glass inserts, view through the backyard, that is. I love the colors here. You have a lighter color scheme. It's staged. It looks great. Property is a wonderful location in St. Petersburg as well. You have community amenities with a park with a playground, fenced-in dog parks, water along the water, soccer fields, scenic trails, pickleball courts, and more. Check out C. Robin Drive, St. Petersburg, another one of our hot listings. 1950 58th Avenue North, Unit 8. Just did a price improvement here. Owner is motivated. This is a great rental property, or maybe you want to live on the ground floor. You have a beautiful community pool, two-bedroom, two-bath, one carport. Right out your back door, you have the carport there. You got a bonus room, 815 square foot condo. You got new HVAC system, electrical panel, ground floor unit, 55 plus community, living room, dining room combo, stainless steel appliances, beautiful property at 1950 58th Avenue North, Unit 8, St. Petersburg, Florida. You can see all of our listings at platinummvpteam.kw.com. Try that in a small town. See how far you make it down. All right, we're talking with Jim Mccune here, America First Patriot Store, AmericaFirstPatriotStore.com. And you had mentioned, too, a little bit about West Virginia and the football days back in the day and your brother. And just it's an interesting story. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
My brother Alan was, he was a great quarterback at West Virginia University. Actually, he was the Sports Illustrated Back of the Week of the Nation. When they beat Pitt 63-48, he threw five touchdown passes. And
nice.
That was back in the day, they didn't even pass like
didn't
they did
throw
today.
As much.
Right, right. And but he was also a great basketball player. When he was a sophomore in high school, he averaged 29.9 points a game.
Wow.
Led the state in scoring, and that was before the 3 points.
Wow.
You know, it would have been 40 plus. But yeah. So great, great guy. Great.
Pretty cool, man. I like that. We like to talk about the old days, don't
we?
As athletes. Yeah. All right, Jim, tell us a little bit more about America First Patriot Store.
Well, as I said earlier, a lot of people don't realize how much money goes for the advertising with the big woke media companies that don't care anything about you and me, that's for sure.
Yep.
And when you become a member, this month it's only a dollar for a whole year's membership. You get 30-40% discount on everything they have when you're a member. Everything's 100% satisfaction guarantee, and you can be a customer forever. You can opt out anytime you want to. And that's it really simply. It's just switching the dollars you're already spending to an American manufacturer that supports freedom. And I always tell people, if healthier, more affordable products delivered right to your door within 2 to 3 days is the kind of club you that sounds good to you, then you ought to go to AmericanFirstPatriotStore.com and just check everything out.
That's right. Check it out and take action. If you're the type of people that take action, I know a lot of our audience will. AmericanFirstPatriotStore.com. Jim Mccune, thanks for coming in, buddy.
Thank you. Great.
Appreciate it.
Great to be here with you.
Absolutely. Good to have you, man. All right. We're going to take a quick break, come back and talk more with Alex Blackbelt Lima in studio here. Coming up as well, Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum contractor, expert, contributor on the program. And follow us online. We'd love to connect with you at BrandonRimes1 at CQB Show. And subscribe to the Rumble and YouTube channel so you can catch all the previous episodes. Lots of great content there. Over 2,600 plus videos now posted online. So you can really dive into some great content there. Coming up, Consumer Quarterback Show, ConsumerQB.com.
Hey, I'm Ken Shamrock, and you're here with Consumer Quarterback Show.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Grimes here, your host, Consumer Quarterback Show, powered by the Platinum MVP team at Keller Williams Realty, helping you win in your real estate deals. If you're buying, selling, or investing, of course, we would love to talk to you. Your local real estate economist of choice, over 100 listings now with the Platinum MVP team. We're doing everything from vacant land, commercial deals, residential deals, pre-construction condos. We got those beautiful pre-construction condos in Gainesville, Florida as well. My wife Lindsay and the team are operating that location for the builder developer up in Gainesville on Archer Place. Check out Archer Place if you're interested in those. We're going to be talking with Alex Black Belt Lima here on the Consumer Quarterback Show. Talk a little current events, a little self-defense, as well as martial arts and summer camp going on there as well. All right, we got a hot listing here at 10413 Main Street. This one's in Thanona, Sassa, East Hillsborough County, that is. We have 3.63 acres of vacant land. Zone PD, property style, is commercial. The bustling city of Thanona, Sassa, across the street from a busy gas station, close to the vibrant pulse of Tampa as well. A great opportunity to own real estate here in Tampa Bay. Buy and build. That's the idea here. 10413 Main Street, Thanona, Sassa. Another one of our over 100 listings. You can see all of our listings online on our website, of course. 4501 Garnett Drive. This one's Newport Richie. Now, beautiful property here. Great opportunity. Waterfront townhome. Two bedrooms, 2.5 bath, 2215 square feet. 4501 Garnett Drive. You have canal frontage, bay access to the Gulf of Mexico. Giant 15 by 30 family room. Beautiful large street courtyard, grand entry, open floor plan, cathedral ceiling. You have fireplace in the great room and a lot of updates and upgrades here. Waterfront clubhouse, a heated pool, tennis courts, private community boat ramp, plenty of parking as well. Two bedrooms, 2.5 bath at 4501 Garnett Drive, Newport Richie, Florida. And you can see all of our listings at platinummvpteam.kw.com. All right, quick shout out to Replenish IV Solutions, longtime friends of the Consumer Quarterback Show. Replenish IV Solutions. I love going down to their Gandy location and getting that vitamin infusion drip directly into my bloodstream. All the good vitamins, all the B's, all the C's. Something like the Myers cocktail is kind of a popular one that people know. Check them out online. Let them know the Real Estate Quarterback Center. ReplenishIVSolutions.com. ReplenishIVSolutions.com. Make sure you let them know Real Estate Quarterback sent you. All right, here's our feel-good story of the day. Tell me something good. All right, so families in a Texas town have adopted 77 hard-to-adopt kids inspired by their Baptist church leader. So we'd like to tell you something positive here. Here's a good one for you. So here's a small-town name for you. Possum Trot, Texas. You ever hear Possum Trot, Texas? Sounds like a small town. Inspired by their Baptist church leaders, families from this small town community have adopted 77 of the most at-risk children from the regional foster system. The story recounted in the film Sound of Hope, the story of Possum Trot began when Pastor Bishop W.C. Martin and his wife Donna adopted two children and encouraged their congregation to do the same. The town's 23 households united to provide loving homes for these children. The film, directed by Josh Weigel, highlights the transformative power of community and faith. It received positive reviews and grossed $9.5 million within 2 weeks of its release. Bishop Martin emphasized that if every church focused on adopting a few children, it could significantly impact the foster care system. And there you have it. Another great story from Angel Studios. Alex, they're the ones that put out that awesome series called The Chosen, which I really love. It tells the stories of the disciples and Jesus and all the different, raising of the dead and the healing and the sacrifices made. And it also has, Angel Studios also put out that really cool movie
Sound of
about
Freedom.
A year ago.
Yeah, yes,
Sound of Freedom.
Tim Ballard story.
But yeah, this is something we've talked about before on the show, just, you know, with the abortion issue being such a highly contested, you bring up that issue, it's like, man, you almost have 50% here, 50% there, right? But when you think about it, should it really be that way? Couldn't it be a different solution where we push adoption a lot more?
Yeah, you know, there are some options. I mean, I'm still in the school of thought that they're, you know, like in cases of rape and incest and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, that person, unfortunately, has already been burdened enough, is going to need years and years of, you know, refixing themselves.
But that's less than 1%.
It's still
that's
a percentage,
what, that's what they always
though.
Go to.
It's still a percentage, though, Brandon.
Super low.
And it's, but it's still something that needs to be addressed, man. So we can't cut that off for,
well,
you
that's
know,
the
everybody.
Common sense approach. Yeah. That's
but,
everybody
but
agrees
I,
with that.
It's still, I'm not giving everybody a free pass to where, hey, you can, you know, you can go have sex with whoever you want, and just because you're reckless and careless and you get pregnant, you can go and have an abortion. You know,
right.
I'm not with that either. I think people should need to be more responsible overall. You know?
Yeah, absolutely. But and when we talked to State Representative Bernie Jocks on the program, I like what he had mentioned, because they are making they're clearing some of the red tape for the adoption process. My wife Lindsay and I, as you know, and some of the listeners that have heard, you know, we looked into fostering. We were trying to get pregnant, had issues there. We're going to foster. We got our licensing, so we were going to look at fostering, and then that sometimes will turn into an adoption, and it may be in the cards for the future. Who knows? But you know, I think it's really you know, the name Angel Studios, and to have angels like this that take and adopt children, bring them into their home, especially these hard to adopt ones. You know, the teenagers and things of that nature, that where they have these bad habits already created.
Dude, 77 of them though.
Yeah,
like that's a lot of people. And I was as that story, as you were reading it, I was going through in my head, and I was like, man, that's a lot. And you know, from firsthand experience, I'm a proponent, and I wouldn't be an advocate and speak for people that, hey, you know, life ain't fair. It's not fair. There's a lot of issues in life. There's people that shouldn't be parents. There's people, you know, there's world is a messed up, screwed up place.
Yep.
And these people go and adopt all these children that off bat, they're already not given a fair shake in life.
Yep.
What greater purpose is there in life than to be a vessel to give people a chance, a fair chance? So life isn't fair.
Sure.
But they're bringing these kids into their home, and it's like, we're going to give you a chance. We're giving you a stable home. We're giving you a foundation that you did not have before.
That's right.
But now it's what you go and do with it. You know, so I mean, man, what greater purpose than that, than to give people like a some backing?
Yeah.
You know?
It's angels, man. It's salt of the earth. It's good people doing that. And it was a Baptist church leader that did that. So I love that. Let's switch gears. I want to talk. It's been a little while since we spoke about self-defense and martial arts, and you know, I know you got your summer camp going, you're helping kids as well. What's your thoughts around that right now?
Yeah, fitness too. We never touch sometimes on the fitness side, because the world is always so crazy. We're typically speaking about the you know, the self-defense side and stuff and everything. You know, business is it's great. You know, in the post-COVID world, we have you know, we're able to go out and do our sporting events and stuff again. We just did World Class Fight League a couple weekends ago at the downtown Tampa. That was good. And, you know, I was thinking as I coach these guys, I mean, I've always just done this stuff my whole life. I never thought I envisioned myself as being like the OG on the mat.
Yeah,
you know, the old guy. Like, I walk in, they're like, "Hey, coach," and I'm like, "Yeah, I guess he's talking to me."
Isn't it funny how we transition from that,
bro? It's crazy, yeah. And it's for me, it's like it came out of nowhere. I'm just hitting a bag, and just time kept passing by, you know.
Yeah,
and you know, I'm training sometimes and teaching kids that are, you know, I do my kids' classes, like, you know, the stuff my daughter and stuff is in, but I work with guys that are, you know, in 20 and up, and their 30s and stuff too. But you know, my 20-year-old guys, and I'm like, dude, I've been doing martial arts since before you were born, son.
Yeah,
like, you know what
exactly.
I'm saying? Like, I've been doing this stuff and training and fighting since before you were born. So it's been a wild ride and journey, but I wouldn't change it, you know, at all.
Injuries and it's more relevant. You know? It's now more than ever. I think it's relevant to have a background like that, or at least to know the basics, right?
Yeah, I think it's always been important. But yeah, for sure. Now, if I just don't understand what it's going to take for people to put more value on their ability to defend themselves and protect themselves and their family and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, how many, unfortunately, we're living in a world where how many shootings do you got to see?
Yeah.
How many times do you got to hear about an abduction? How many times do you have to hear about the kid being bullied and pushed too far?
Yeah.
You know, it's just what has to happen in order for someone to be shaken up enough to take that initial step and to walk into that gym and be like, hey man, I need to learn how to defend myself. My situation is different. I started at a young age and I just kind of never stopped. So my mindset has always been like this. So I truly have a difficult time understanding why people don't take that leap and take that step. You know, I guess it can be intimidating. I don't know.
Isn't it over the years, if you just joined us, by the way, I'm talking to Alex Blackbelt Lima here on the Consumer Quarterback Show. He's our producer. He's also a expert in all things protection, self-defense, martial arts, a champion in many ways there. I'm your host, Brandon Rimes. But Alex, haven't you told me too, or I know at least some of the people in your sphere have directly been in a situation where there was an attempted rape or some type of a mugging, and then they come to you, right?
Oh, no doubt, man. You know, that's one thing. If people, don't typically take action until after an event has occurred, and it's like, well, no, now it's too late. You've already been jumped or you've already been attacked, you know?
Yeah.
But what we can do is give you the skill set to prevent that from ever happening in the future. Get rid of, you will never be a victim again.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, you know, whether it's been at a seminar or it's been with private one-on-one lessons, especially when I do seminars, like I did a seminar for St. Pete College. They invited me to come out and teach it's called Women's on the Way. It was an all women's group.
Yep.
And there was like, I don't know, 80, 100 women out there. It was pretty crazy. It was a pretty big event. I was actually very blessed to be a part of that. And you know, after that event, I had multiple people come up to me and being like, man, I wish I would have known some of this stuff sooner. And they started telling me their stories. And
yeah,
that's something that unfortunately has happened more too many times than I'd like to count or admit, you know.
Yeah.
I had a client that I was training that, I've been training this person for years, and they finally came to me and told me they were like a victim of like an assault.
Wow.
And I'm like, man, you know, I can always, it's to a point where I can almost kind of tell who's got that. When you take it, there's one thing to like learn a little bit of self-defense and to get in shape and be fit, but some people have a different fire inside them that make them like a real fighter.
Yeah.
You know, I believe everybody can fight.
Yeah.
You can be taught the skills to fight and stand your ground, but there's something that's unique in some of us that makes us like a real fighter, like a real warrior, you know, and I can kind of tell. And you know what typically the common factor in that is, the common denominator, is the person has been a victim of something. They felt something or were treated in a way or were in a scenario that they swore to themselves. You made a pledge to yourself that you're never going to feel that way again.
They make it a must. That's what Tony Robbins said.
Priority,
they
make it top a
must.
Priority.
It's a must that we do this. We have to do this. And you burn the boats and you take the island and you have no escape. All right, good stuff there. So Black Belt, how do people connect with you? Is it on your IG?
Yeah, you can always check me out on Instagram and socials at BlackBelt_fitness. You can always call 813-426-1588, Black Belt Fitness and Martial Arts Club, and you can catch me every week over at American Top Team in Tampa. So
I love it. I love it. Good stuff. All right, we're going to take a quick break, come back and talk to our expert contributor in all things contracting. He's our contracting expert contributor, Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum, AKA the Tin Man, coming up here on the Consumer Quarterback Show, plus our couple of properties that we like to feature every segment. We feature our real estate listings. Coming up, Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum, Consumer Quarterback Show, ConsumerQB.com.
Hey, I'm Ken Shamrock, and you're here with Consumer Quarterback Show. And I say, Brandon Rhymes, knock out your competition.
To get in touch with Brandon, call 727-263-3707. Online at ConsumerQB.com.
Lindsay Rhymes here. My husband Brandon and I own the Platinum MVP team at Keller Williams. And our team of seasoned agents is ready to help you buy, sell, invest, and love the life you live here in Tampa Bay. Communication, execution, customer service, and bulletproofing transactions are really where our team shines. We service Hillsborough, Pinellas, Manatee, Pasco, Hernando, and Citrus counties, and we have seasoned agents in residential, luxury land, and commercial divisions. Reach out to us, your Christian Realtors, and let us help empower you with the right knowledge to make smart decisions with your next transaction. Call us at 727-263-3707 today. Again, that number is 727-263-3707.
Selling commercial, vacant land, or residential properties? Don't leave money on the table. List with the Platinum MVP team at Keller Williams Realty. I'm Brandon Rhymes. You can reach me at 727-263-3707. Call or text 727-263-3707 online at consumerqb.com.
You're listening to The Consumer Quarterback, Brandon Rhymes, online at ConsumerQB.com. Brandon is Tampa Bay's number one consumer advocate for real estate and financial advice. Call Brandon today at 813-917-1894.
And we're back. Brandon Rhymes here, Consumer Quarterback Show, powered by the Platinum MVP team at Keller Williams Realty, helping you win in your real estate deals, buying, selling, or investing. We would love to talk to you.
Fred Muth joining us here momentarily. Tampa Screens and Aluminum, a.k.a. the Tin Man. We're going to talk with him about the contracting industry and what he's seeing out there. And before we do, a couple of hot listings here. Rustling Wind is a property that we have. This is another vacant land parcel that we have for sale. We've got over 100 listings and a about a third, maybe even less, is our vacant land category. Rustling Wind Road, Brooksville. We got 4.5 acres, 4.5 acre parcel of land. You got no homeowners association or CDD. And you are located just a stone's throw away from a myriad of modern amenities. Short drive to a variety of dining options, shopping, entertainment, medical centers, and schools. Easy access to the Suncoast Parkway and other main roads. Check out Zero Rustling Wind Road, Brooksville, Florida. 4.5 acres of land. Build a home there. 5198 40th Street South. And this one's over in St. Petersburg, Florida. 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 2-car garage, 3,000 plus square foot, beautifully renovated interior, screened in back patio, spacious living room, open floor plan in the heart of Maximo Moorings. You have stainless steel appliances, breakfast bar, and primary ensuite has a complete with dual sinks as well. And you're close to the Tiki Docks there, Skyway Bar and Tiki Docks. And another great listing from the Platinum MVP team. You can see all of our listings at platinummvpteam.kw.com. All right, Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum, back on the line, back on the show. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing great. Is it the Brandon Alex team today?
That's right. It sure is.
Yes, sir.
All right. Here's one for you. With half my brains tied behind.
Say again?
Oh, you. I guess you don't go back that far.
I missed it. I missed that one. No.
All right. I forget it. Okay, we'll talk about it tonight. I'll be at the party tonight.
Okay, good. We'll be at the party tonight. Yeah, so I was thinking it's the QB and the black belt. We got the QB and the black belt in here, man.
Oh, boy. Yeah, I don't want to argue with either one of you guys. Anyway, so the screen business is just doing fantastic. You know, it's hurricane season, and I always, you know, being on the air, I always like to recommend to homeowners a couple things that, you know, don't panic. The cages are built pretty strong. I mean, if your cage is 20, 30 years old, it may take a hit. I recall when Charlie went through back in 04, you know, a lot of the cages were, 15, 20 years old, and quite a few of them just lost the fabric, you know, so these things are built pretty well. My suggestion is don't cut the screens. Some people say, I'll go out there and cut the screens. It'll be less, you know, less wind and this and that and the other. Don't do that. That's really not necessary. I've seen the demonstrations on the cages where the wind the fabric in the rolled into the extrusion can typically withstand up to about 128, 129 miles an hour. And then it comes out of the spline groove.
Right.
Now, if it's old fabric, 5-6 year old fabric, it's probably going to tear. So there's no reason to cut your screens.
Yeah, because you're not lending any support to the actual building itself, the metal building, the aluminum building, right? It'd just pop out.
That's right. I mean, people think that if you cut the fabric, the wind's going to rush through faster, which typically it will, but in reality, the cages are built to withstand that. The fabric's built to withstand up to 128, 129 miles an hour, so you might as well let nature do its thing and let nature take the fabric out, and then the frame should stay there. So that's my suggestion. Another thing is the failure points on the cages has always been where they connect, up to the house, up to the fascia board, the connection there, at the base where the tap cons go in and secure it to the pool deck. These are areas that you really should check out before the storms hit. If you have loose tap cons, if you have bad tap cons, they're the ones that go into the pool deck. You can run to Home Depot, get some tap cons and drill them in yourself. It's something that a lot of people will do. Or call a screen company, but typically it takes a while to get somebody out to do that kind of work on a screen contracting company. The connection point at the house is very important. Make sure that you're real tight up against the gutter. Make sure that if there's rotted wood up there, keep an eye on that, because if there's rotted fascia board and your super gutter is attached to the fascia board and the winds hit, heavy 60, 70, 80 mile an hour, that could pull away. So these are just some tips for the homeowners.
Yeah, what other tips you got? I like the idea of consumer advocate tips. We're talking with Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum.
and he can add on to that beautiful home of yours. He can put on beautiful, you know, it's patio, screen room, lanai, goes by a lot of names, porch, but we call it that in-between space, don't we, Fred?
I like that. That makes more sense, because I have people come down here from the Northeast. They say to me they want a lanai, and I say, okay, let's talk about the scope of work. And I'll say, what do you consider a lanai? So they'll say, in some cases, they'll say to me, I'm not sure. I went to see a guy on Monday, and he's from New York, and he says, I need to understand what we're doing here. And I go up, and I talk to him, and now he's got a completely different viewpoint of what a lanai can be. A lanai can be basically a patio room with screen walls. It could be a covered area that was built into the house. That could be considered a lanai. A pool cage could be considered a lanai. So it's just a very generic term. And we like to break it down to patio room, screen enclosure, pool enclosure, screened in solid roof room, that type of thing. We always like to, when we talk about the scope of work, we need to know exactly what the homeowners want. But a lot of times they don't know. For example, the one I went to see on Monday, what he wanted was very acceptable. Some of these HOA communities, they won't allow certain things. Like, for example, quite a few will not allow the aluminum composite roofs unless you put a shingle on top, and then that changes the cost significantly. And that's doable. We've done that. We don't actually put a shingle. It's called a modified shingle product, where it's a rolled on product that typically mimics the look of the shingle, and it adds some more leak protection and this and that and the other. But it drives the cost up significantly, because you have to jump from a standard 3-inch foam core panel up to a 4-inch foam core panel. There's all these things involved. But I, when people come down from the Northeast and they're in the community and they're not aware of the HOA requirements, we try to educate them based on our history in that certain community. And quite often I'll request the documents, and basically the documents are in an email form. And if they email them documents to me, there may be 60, 80 pages. But I know right where to go in the declarations to find the restrictions on patios and screen enclosures, etc.
How's your permitting process looking now?
It's actually getting a little better. I hope I didn't jinx myself. We're starting to get them a little bit faster. You know, I think what happens when things slow down, of course, things are a little slower now with the decline in home sales. Obviously, less homes are being built, so there's more room in the building department to get that screen enclosure permit through much faster.
Gotcha. And about 30 seconds or so, final thought. Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum. You can see him online at consumerqb.com. And final thought.
Well, any homeowner should ask as many questions that comes to mind when you're bidding out a project. Don't feel intimidated by asking questions, because, for example, myself and the people with Tampa Screens, we welcome the questions. We love the questions. That way we know going into the project, there's no hidden anything. And on the back end, when the job is done, we hope for no surprises. So if I'm explaining the project and, for example, the homeowner doesn't quite hear what I'm saying, then he may come back and ask me, bingo, we covered it.
I love it. Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum, how do you want people to connect?
It's always best by phone, 813-960-7064.
All right, online at consumerqb.com as well. Fred Muth, Tampa Screens and Aluminum, longtime friend of the Consumer Quarterback Show, doing a great job out there. We appreciate you, Fred.
You got it. See us tonight.
All right, see ya. Please go out there and consider committing a random act of kindness. Do something kind for one another. Be a force for good in the community. And we'll see you next time right here on the Consumer Quarterback Show, consumerqb.com.
You've been listening to the Consumer Quarterback, Brandon Rhymes. Weather.